हेलो ऑल, माय सेल्फ मिसेस माधवी नावरकर फ्रॉम केकेवाक पॉलिटेक्निक नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक रिलेशनल मॉडल फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ डेटाबेस। बिफोर रिलेशनल मॉडल वी हैड जस्ट सीन दैट व्हाट इज डेटा मॉडल। डेटा मॉडल और डेटाबेस मॉडल, इट इज़ द लॉजिकल डिजाइन एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द डेटाबेस विच डिस्क्राइब्स हाउ द डेटा विल बी स्टोर्ड, accessed and updated in the DBMS. And there are different data models like hierarchical model, network model, object oriented model, entity relationship model and relational model. But among these five models, the relational model is the most popular data model and which is most widely used for the database related operations. This relational model was first proposed by the research person Mr. Ager Kord. Hence, this person is known as father of the relational model. Relational model is basically an attempt to simplify the database structure by making use of tables and columns. As every person or every student knows the table. Table is a collection of rows and columns. It is a simple structure. So Mr. Ager Kord has given the simplification of database just by using the rows and columns. In relational model, the tables are called as relations, the columns are known as attributes, and the rows or records are known as tuples. So these relations, attributes, and tuples, these are the words in the language of database. A relational database, that is, which is basically driven or basically designed by using relational model, is the collection of two-dimensional table which consists of rows and columns. Now there are different concepts under relational model. The first one is attribute. Attribute is what? It is the named column of a relation. As we know, the table is a collection of columns and rows, then every row and column is going to have some name, and the column is named as attribute. Whatever name you are giving for that column, that will be considered as a attribute. For example, see this table. There are total three columns. And the names given are customer ID, customer name and status. So this customer table has customer ID, customer name and status as the attributes. Second concept under relational model is tuple. Tuple is basically known as row. Row means the horizontal part in the table. Row can also be considered as a record. So tuple can also be called as record or row. For example, in this table, data of one customer in one row is called as tuple. Means, suppose the customer ID is 1, the name of that customer is Google, and the status is active, then this whole horizontal part is called as one row or one tuple or one record. Then the next concept is relation. Relation is nothing but the table. Relation is the word in relational model. And relation is the collection of rows and columns. And those tables are used to hold the information about the objects to be represented in the database. Now see, here I had given the customer information. And the name of this table is the customer. So the name of the relation is customer because I had inserted all the information related to customer. Then the next concept is domain. Domain is the set of permitted values for one or more attributes. We can say that permitted or possible values. It can also be defined as the potential values that an attribute may hold. Means domain is the vertical part in the table. As the column has the name, that name will be considered as an attribute, and under that attribute, whatever potential values, what are the possible values you are inserting, that whole line is called as domain. See, we will see this by example. Now this table has three columns. Now for the customer name, I had entered Google, Amazon and Apple. So these three are the values for the customer name. So this whole part is the domain for the customer name. Means we can say that Google, Amazon and Apple are the possible customer names for the customer name attribute. Same thing we can say that for the customer ID, the possible values are 1, 2 and 3. So the domain of customer ID is between 1, 2 and 3. So domain is the vertical part in the table. Now we have seen the different concepts or terms of relational model. Now we will see the advantages of relational model. It is easy to use. As we have seen, it is a tabular form structure. It consists of rows and columns, so it is easy to understand. Then flexibility. In relational model, information from multiple tables can be retrieved easily at a time by joining the tables. Means if there are two tables, then you can join the tables easily. So it is flexible to connect two tables and to get one table or to get more data. Then security. Security control and authorization can also be implemented more easily by moving sensitive attributes in a given table into a separate relation with its own authorization controls. Now here the security is provided by using the username password. Suppose you are going to use the Oracle. Then for Oracle there is one username and password. But in Oracle, the security is given that the password should be entered while installing the Oracle. And they are not going to permit your username. The Oracle gives one username, that is the system. And if you want to give the security for the tables, then if there are some confidential attributes, some sensitive attributes, then those attributes can be transferred to another table. Then data manipulation language. Now it is easy to respond to query by means of SQL. Means by using structured query language, you can perform different manipulation functions like insert, update, delete, select, like this. So these are the advantages of relational model. Now there is one disadvantage of relational model, that is hardware overhead. Means this model needs more powerful computing hardware and data storage devices to perform DBMS assigned task. Means whatever software you are using for DBMS operations, that software needs more powerful hardware, more storage device and more sized RAM. So this is only one disadvantage for relational model. Okay, so in this video we have seen the theory of relational model, different concepts under relational model, advantages and disadvantages. Thank you.